like to once again thank everybody for being here this evening. It's been a great day. Amen. We had quite the transition take place. And in that transition, we had about 160, 170 junior camp leave, and we had about 190 senior camp come in. Nobody drove over anybody. Everybody got home and everybody got here, and I say, praise the Lord. Amen. We're happy that everybody's here tonight. We'd like to greet you all. And tonight, I'm going to go right to some scripture, and I've got a couple of things that I would like to say before it goes on. This is senior camp. This is not junior camp. We've basically got all evening. We just say whatever the Lord has. That's what we want. We believe we're in a serious time and a serious hour. We say the rapture could take place. You had Brother Sam stand up and say my theophany. Well, if we've got to start living what we sing and what we say. So if we actually believe that I'm going to step in my theophany and it could happen right now at this time, there are some people that aren't going to go in the right direction. And that's why we have camp, because there's too many fence sitters. Too many fence sitters, saints. Too late in the game. We're in the last lap. This is a serious time. And you say, Brother Tom, why are you coming this way? Because I and you have been in the last services. And God has moved in a supernatural way. Amen. And the pastor spoke on Sunday morning, the rich young ruler. I have waited before the Lord to find the mind of God. Just even for what we do, whatever we do for the children. We don't just open our Bibles and sing some songs. We ask God, Lord, what could we do to help your children, to raise them up a little higher, that you would speak to them, not for entertainment. We've done this now for close to 20 years. We've put different 45, 47 presentations, and God has moved supernaturally in them. And we're not doing this tonight to entertain you. We are doing this by the scripture, so that now that would become alive to you. And you say, it's going to be pretty heavy. It's going to be heavy. And it's not any heavier than what the scripture says. Now we say we're in the third pull. How many believe that we're in the third pull? Young people, you've heard too much about the third pull. But a part of the third pull is speaking to the doomed. And now I want you to get that locked in your mind. Your prophet said that a part of the third pull was to speak to the doomed. That is where we're at right now. He says, now in souls that are in prison. He said, immediately after that, he entered into Babylon. And he went down into Sodom. He never found them, so the fire fall. He found Lot and his two daughters to get them out there right now. He went out and he went down there. But remember, he was on his road down and he sent messengers before them. But he went down himself, speaking now to Abraham's group. He went down himself to Abraham's group. He sent two messengers down to Lot to find out. And he found out in Sodom, full of painted faced women, the message to the doomed. Now that's powerful. And you say, why? Why are we at this junction? Because Brother Biscoe preached the rich young ruler on Sunday morning. And 2 weeks prior to that, I had already had Sister Corrine, my wife, Michael. We were at our home. We were looking to the Lord for what we would put on. And we had already laid out an outline. And we just about fell off our chairs Sunday morning, hearing how the Holy Spirit was leading us, I believe, into this camp. And I believe that that could be a confirmation into your hearts. Where are we at? Where are we at? I believe we're right there at the crossing over. Now I'm challenging you, young people, where are you at? Rich young rulers, let's just say rich Laodicea. This is a rich age. I was in Poland speaking at a youth camp, and a brother that was ministering with me, he had brought over some CDs, and there was over 260 young people that have traveled from White Russia, Czech Republic, Hungary. And they offered the CD at cost, $10, to the young people just to help them out. And the young people came to me and said, "Brother Tom, we couldn't put $2 together from the 260 some odd people. We're living in a rich land. You are rich young people. You can either be rich in Christ or rich in the world. You are either on the right side or the wrong side. And if you're on the wrong side, get on the right side. If you're on the fence, get off the fence and get on the right side." Serious, it's serious. Why? It's your soul. And that's, to me, worth everything. Your soul. So tonight we're going to take from the scripture out of Luke 16, verse 19, if you don't mind standing one more time. Luke 16, verse 19, the Bible says, "And there was a certain rich man, which was clothed in purple and fine linen, and fared sumptuously every day. And there was a certain beggar named Lazarus, which laid at his gate full of sores, desiring to be fed with the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. Moreover, the dogs came and licked his sores. And it came to pass that the beggar died and carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. And the rich man also died and was buried." And verse 23 says, "And in hell he lifted up his eyes, being in torments, and seeth Abraham afar off, and Lazarus in his bosom. He cried and said, Father Abraham, have mercy on me. Send Lazarus that he might dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am tormented in this flame. And Abraham said, Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receiveth the good things, and likewise Lazarus evil things. But now he is comforted, and thou art tormented." Let's pray. Father, you see the burden of our hearts. You see the desires of our souls, Lord, to see a people birthed into the kingdom of God. And Father, we have a desire to see our young people live in victory. We have a desire to see them come into an experience with Christ. Lord, we want to do our part, Lord, so that on that day that we might hear, "Well done, thou faithful servant." Lord, we want to do our part at this camp. Lord, we want to give them every opportunity, Lord, not to turn away from the voice of God, but to hear the voice and say, "Lord, here am I. Father, speak to me." So, Lord, I'm asking that you will speak to every heart in divine presence, that you will be glorified through this reenactment, that it would be inspired to their hearts, and, Lord, that lives would be touched and changed. We commit now to you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may have your seats.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to the greatest marketplace in all of Jerusalem, east of the Mediterranean, in case you didn't know. I love money. I love to spend money, somebody else's money. Would you like me to help you spend your money? Come with me. I have fine stuff, fine. We have oranges, sweet as honey. We have bread, oh bread, fresh, fresh as the spring. We have garlic. We have leeks, carrots. Oh, we've got a ton of stuff. But let me tell you, I, Schumann, have a deal for you. We have the most greatest, greatest juggler of all, oh dear, Jerusalem. Look at that, isn't it amazing? Give him a hand. Oh my goodness. Oh, let me get that for you. Well, that is very talented, dude. I would like to try that. Is it hard? I've never done it before.
Not at all.
Good, good. Let's see here. Mm-hmm. So, throw in circle. Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
Do I have to move the other one? Or does it just keep on going?
Good.
Oh. Did I do it? Mm-hmm. I know I have many talents, many talents. Musicians. Oh, we have the finest guitarist, I must say. Music, yes. Music. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. What is that smell? Ah, Lazarus. Yes, Lazarus.
Alms? Alms?
Lazarus. Not today, not today. Lazarus spends most of his time sitting at the gates of the rich young ruler. Awful smell. Pity them. Oh well. And here, well, this is my helper here. Helps him with the sales. Keeps it going, the business. What do we have for sale today? Bread, I see. How much is it? Why don't I see the sale sign? Get that going. Well, tell me.
Oh, come off it. You talk too much. Why don't we talk about Reuben, the richest of rulers? Oh, so handsome, wonderful, and he's still single? He throws such magnificent parties. Oh, the last one, he had such a feast. I'm still showing on my waistline.
Yes, yes. But please, let's not talk about that. Let's talk about something. Let's get down to business, people. Let's get down to business. We need to get things going here. Snap, snap.
Come on, come on to the superstar, a one-stop shop in town. Pick up your thread, pick up your bread. Up the latest that is being said. So have you heard the latest word that Reuben's on his way? He is so rich, he is so smart, so good, so kind, be still my beating heart.
Honest to the core.
The choir, proper attire, his songs inspire.
How could you ask for more?
He knows the Holy Scriptures. He faithfully pays his tithes.
You just can't lay a finger on his prayer.
great one is coming. Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome!
Thank you! This is my dear mother.
Oh, pleasure to meet you.
I don't think I've met you.
I've heard so much about you, though.
Oh, beauty.
The beauty of the marketplace. I will come to love.
Oh,
since
yes.
I've just bought this store.
Yes,
hello?
It looks great, doesn't it?
Ruben?
Great. How are things in the new business of bazaaring?
Very well, very well.
Yes? Do we have any sales receipts for the day?
Yes, we do, right here.
You know, the traffic coming through at this area.
It's been quite slow today, but we do have a few.
Slow today? How about yesterday and the day before?
We've been at about
a week at it or so.
Yes, not bad. We'll get there.
We'll get there.
Yes, we will.
My analysis of this was a little bit better than we'll get there, so I'm sure... We must pour into it a little bit more.
We will. You are a fine businessman. We will.
All taught by my father. Wonderful businessman.
Gifted.
I know we can do better. I know we can do it. We should maybe up on our marketing a little bit.
Yes.
Maybe get the store. What do you think, Shudman?
Yes.
We should do that.
Yes.
Yeah. Will you talk to a marketing agency and let's
down.
Work on
Put
getting the presence of this of the new the store.
Yes.
Maybe the area is just not known to everybody.
Yes.
Not bad results for first opening week, but I'd like to look into it a little bit more.
Yes.
Definitely, Master.
So, yourself, Shudman, I would like to talk to you maybe a little later.
Yes.
We're looking into possibly acquiring some new property of such and whatnot, and your architect skills are going to definitely come
in handy.
Thank you. You are the best architect in the world that I know of.
Thank you.
Alms,
mother.
Alms
for the poor.
No, mother. Shoo. But go beg somewhere else, sir. This way. Away from our
Ruben. Ruben.
Yes, mother. Yes.
My dear son, you must never look down on those who are less fortunate than you.
It's just bad. It just doesn't look good, mother.
Oh, but my dear, you have so much to learn. Listen, Ruben. God has blessed our family immensely with not only wealth but, well, friends and relations and business associates, but never must we ever not be thankful for that. And the way that we show our thankfulness to God is to give of what we do have to those who are less fortunate. And in return, God will bless you even more abundantly.
Those are good words, Mother. I must...
Ruben!
Hey, Wawa! Hey!
Another one.
That is shameful.
Mother!
Yes, Ruben.
Then, from what you're telling me, I should let him go. I should maybe let him take the loaf that he just stole.
Do what is in your heart, Ruben.
Interesting teachings. I agree. I definitely agree. Those are wonderful teachings. They make me feel good inside too. I like that. I think, I will do that more. I will try to do that more. Yes, of course, God has blessed us, but... And there are those like the beggar that doesn't have much. He has to beg. That would be terrible. So the least I can do is give him some bread. Shakala, put that bread, pretend that I bought it, mark it up like I've purchased it, and put it through the sales of such.
Thank you.
And then it will look like we've had more sales.
You're very kind.
Yes.
You are very quick with your lessons, my son.
Well, only because I have a good teacher.
You never do cease to make me proud.
Well, it's none of my credit, for sure. Let us go.
We shall.
Let's, servant, let's...
Come, Lydia.
Have you purchased everything you needed, Mother?
We have everything.
All right.
Two loaves? Two. Okay.
Let us go.
Come.
Good day, thank you.
Watch your step.
Thank you.
Thank you, Shudman. We'll be talking.
We'll see you
all right,
later.
Check it out.
Bye, Ruben.
I'd like daily updates, please.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, might as well pack up for the day.
Yes, it is packing up time. Come along. We've had a very, very long day.
Oh, Rabbi Horowitz. You funny man. You are the scholar of scholar. The theologians of theologians. But yet, you forgot your sandals. Oh, you funny man. Your great mind is getting weak unlike that of a student I have. More than a student. His name is Reuben, and he is a prized possession. He takes pride in wealth. He was first in his class in business 101, 102, 103, to be graduated soon. My Reuben is passionate and dedicated to the scriptures. He's very successful. I'm waiting, as we'll be studying over a lesson right now, from my Reuben.
Always on time, punctuality. Great Rabbi, I'm here.
Oh, Reuben.
How are you?
I'm doing very well.
Wonderful. I'm so eager to get to what our lesson was today. I was running, trying to get to our lessons on time, and I believe I am.
On time, as usual, Reuben.
Wonderful. As long as you call it on time, I am on time.
Now, where were we in our study?
I knew you'd ask me that, so I always would prepare, of course, in case you came up with that question. We were discussing the Ten Commandments. And we were practicing our scripture memorizations, I believe. Is that where we were? Am I correct?
Correct.
Wonderful. What? I will recite them for you. Honor thy father and mother, as the Lord thy God hath commanded thee, that thy days may be prolonged, that it may go well with thee in the land which the Lord God hath given thee. Thou shalt not kill, neither shalt thou commit adultery, neither shalt thou steal. Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
Ah.
How is that?
Reuben, what does that scripture really mean?
The last one I quoted.
Yes. This does not only mean a god as Dagon, but it means a god of pride. A god of jealousy.
Interesting. Meaning anything in life could be a god. Anything put before God could be a god. Pride. Popularity.
Yes.
Money.
Yes.
Interesting. Those are great teachings. I will strive to do that. Of course I will. I'm so glad you teach me. I know it makes my life so much better.
Yes.
Oh, I so appreciate it, Rabbi.
But Reuben.
Yes.
It also means to place God first in your life. In
right.
Everything.
I will strive to do just that, Rabbi. With all that is within me, I will.
I have a question for you. How did Abraham know that there was one true God when many believed in multitudes of gods?
Well, when the Lord God told Abraham and took him out of his country and from his culture, he said, "Go into a land that I will show thee." It was I. It was not we. Secondly, God made man in his own image. In his own image. And he made man, not men, and not many images. Thirdly, no two rabbis can decide upon one thing. How can many gods decide on one thing?
Spoken very well, Reuben. Spoken very well.
Only because it's taught well. I give credit to my teacher.
Thank you.
I've been troubled by one thing, Rabbi. I've been meaning to ask you. What have you to say about this Jesus of Nazareth? He's been teaching different teachings and different doctrines. I wanted to get your feel of what you thought. A thought about what he has to say. I mean, he's been doing great miracles, but it seems the Pharisees and the leaders don't accept what he's teaching. What have you to say?
It is true that a man named Jesus has been around and has spoke many things, some of which I agree with, but there are many things we do not agree with. So I will leave that up to you, for God will have to reveal to you. But I trust once again that you will come to the knowledge of the truth.
Once again, you leave it as an open question for me to decide. I tell you what, Rabbi, I will go and hear what he has to say. And then I will come back, and we can discuss it at next lesson. How does that sound?
Very well, Reuben, very well.
I must go. I will leave you. Thank you for another lesson. I am in such anticipation for our next one.
It's always a joy with you, Reuben.
Thank you. Have a great day.
What a man, this rich young ruler. You hear him speak. Well, he knows the scriptures. So faithful with his rabbi. How could someone like I even have dreams of anything but what I live here? Surely God has such a great place for this man. I remember reading scriptures as a boy, but I couldn't even say one of them now. He committed many of them. What is this man, Jesus? I don't know why that name sounds familiar to me, or maybe I should go and hear what he would say, and I'll hide. I'm not welcome by the people. Not welcome in the synagogue, or maybe I'll hide in some trees and listen to what this man would say. Perhaps it's something that could help me. Man, Jesus.
Ah, my beloved wife, Ruth. How are you today?
Phineas, my dear.
Wonderful. Let us speak of the great things that God has done.
Oh, so many. Not a day ceases that I don't stop and just thank the Lord for his blessings he's given to us.
How many years now?
45.
45. Hardly seems like a day over 25. Ah, how good God has been to us.
Indeed.
Everywhere we look, we see his increase. We see his blessing. And then we think of our son,
Oh, our dear
Reuben.
Son.
What a boy.
I'm so proud of him.
I've taught him in the ways of business, and I have to say I have taught him well. He's in fact surpassed the teacher, I have to say. And yet, my dear, I know you well. Something has been troubling you these last weeks. Tell me,
what is it? It's true. I haven't been able to hide it as well as I wanted, but... I'm concerned, really. Reuben has had everything served to him on a silver spoon.
It's true.
And everything has come so easy. Friends, relations, popularity, riches. It's just... Sometimes I wonder, does he have what it takes? Does he have it inside his heart? Does he appreciate that if it was all taken away, is God still with him?
I understand. I have asked him to come today. We must speak, and I will mention this to him.
Yes.
We will speak on these things.
I think we should.
A mother's heart sees these things better than a father's. Thank you. Ah, and here he comes now. Reuben! Reuben, my boy, come.
Father!
Ah, there he is.
Oh.
How are you, my son?
Oh, I'm well. Yourself?
Oh, bless you.
Oh, so good to see you.
Good to see you. And your mother.
Mother, good to see you, too.
Wonderful. And how is your day?
It is going well.
Wonderful.
Absolutely fantastic.
Mother, you must excuse us. We must speak man to man about these many things that we
you
have on our
call.
Hearts.
Yes, you had
I had my son, and thank you for coming so quickly.
Oh, the moment you call, I come right away. I know anything you have to say is important.
That's my son. That's my son. Let me speak to you. We have spoken of business.
Yes.
And you have learned well. We have spoken of financial matters. And I have turned so many of these things over to you in part. And you have prospered. And look, the family has prospered. You have become a wealthy young man.
Oh, only by your teachings, Father.
Well, let me say this, that there is more that I want to speak to you about. And we have spoken on these things before, Reuben. And yet, I feel in my heart that I must emphasize, and not in the things of business, but in the greater issues of life. I want to speak to you about truth and about honesty. Let your word be your bond.
Yes.
Let your handshake be your guarantee.
Of course.
Give to the poor. We who have been blessed have a responsibility to give to those that have been less fortunate. You, by virtue of your birth, have been blessed. Others have not had that opportunity. And for us, it falls to us to do what we can to ease their load.
I will do just as you say. I could tell in such you're such earnest, and I know it's not such a light thing that you say.
These are the foundations that you build your life upon. And yet, look at you. Here I carry on as an old man, and look at you. Oh, God has blessed this family. Your five older brothers would be so proud of you. And you have been such a blessing to them as well. And yet, let me say, Reuben, a note of caution. Your mother has expressed it. I feel it. I want to speak to you about the call of God in your life. I want to speak to you about the still small voice that would speak to you in the midst of your riches, in the midst of your wealth. And yet, if all that was stripped away, what do we have at the heart of our lives?
Right.
And that's what I would like to speak to you. Find God's voice in your life, Reuben. Find the center of his will for you. And God will bless you more than materially. He will bless you in every way.
I will do just that, Father. I will go home. I would like to ponder on what you have just said to me. I want you not just hear, but I want to apply.
Listen. It's nothing. It's nothing. You have heard me well, my son. We have taught you all we know. And now, I have prepared a great ceremony.
Oh, you should.
In the city gate. Today, we go now, and I read from this scroll. And I make a proclamation to the elders of the city. And I pronounce that my son, Reuben, from this day forward, shall carry the name of our family. Your signature shall be my signature, my son. Your word shall be the same. Your promise shall be equal to mine. From this day forward, my son is a ruler in the land of Israel. And now we go to the city gates. Let us away.
Father, I'm honored. Oh.
We go to the city gates. Mother, join us on this great occasion.
No, I don't mind if I do.
Watch your steps here, Father. Mother, watch your steps.
To the city gates.
Oh, these words. Oh, he's distressed.
Okay.
asked such a thing.
Yes, yes.
Reuben, it's your mother. Is everything okay?
No.
Your father and I are anxious to hear about your meeting with Jesus.
I did meet with him. I did. I would not like to discuss it at this time, Mother. I left not feeling well.
Reuben, it's Father. Open the door, son. We so long to hear about your meeting with the young rabbi of Galilee.
No, Father, I will... how about I talk with you tomorrow?
Are you sure, son?
Yes, everything is truly, it's all right. I'd just like maybe some time alone.
We're down the hall if you need us.
I will call. Thank you.
Good night, dear.
Oh. Why such a thing as this? Simple words, the words of a beggar. I don't understand what this, all that this man spoke about. But, oh God, something touched my heart. Oh God. But it wasn't a man speaking. God, that was you speaking. I don't even know how I know that. I've never heard the voice of God before. I wouldn't even know what it sounded like, but I know that was you, God. And when he spoke, something happened to me. From inside those bushes, I don't know if you saw me. I don't think you saw me. There were thousands there. Wealthy people. Pharisees were there. People of the synagogue. And they walked away. I've looked at these people as being the ones who... They've lived by the law, by the letter of the law every day. And yet they walked away from this man, Jesus. Some angry... I even saw some take up stones as if to stone him. And this man, small in stature, there was nothing to look at. But the words he spoke, the way he would look at the cripple and the lame, and he looked at them with such love. I could see it. I could see those was healed. I could
boils, and I saw those with boils on their arms healed. It was a blind man I saw come up, and he healed him. He could see. What meaneth these things, God? Oh, God, you spoke to me, a beggar, a man who's lived in the dirt all his life. A man who's stolen, who's broken your commandments every day. I took that loaf of bread from that man yesterday. I even heard that he forgave me. And yet you would choose to speak to me? What grace is this? Only your grace, oh God. See a wretch like me hiding in some bush. And to speak to me, decide to reach down your hand and take my heart and change it. Oh, forgive me, oh God. Forgive me. Oh, my sin. Oh, take my life, Lord. Whatever you want to do with me, oh God, change me. I don't care how people see me. They've looked down at me and I don't care. I don't care if they look down at me for the rest of my days, but God, if I know that you were my friend, that would mean everything to me. Take me as I am, oh God. All you want is me. Unreservedly, not just a part, you want all of my heart. All you want is all of me. All you want is me.
Talking with that same one that I had seen. That Jesus. Oh, all too much in one day. I must rest. I must just get this off my mind. Tomorrow I will. Tomorrow, I know by tomorrow morning it would all have cleared and I'll just be able to just to think it all out. I know I must. Rest as I come on mine. These pillows are outrageously thick. Come now, my goodness.
One thing thou lackest. Go thy way, sell whatever thou hast. And give to the poor. One thing thou lackest. One thing thou lackest.
I don't. How must one sleep with such matters on your mind? My. He asked so much of me. I was so eager to go see him. I knew if he just, whatever he told me, I knew would be right. That's what my heart said. My rabbi, he had told me, you know,
maybe. Some things he doesn't agree with, some things he does. And then he comes and he asks me to sell everything I have. He must have not known exactly who I was. I have lands. I have properties, buildings, stores, including the new one I just bought. I have monies in multiple investments. No, it doesn't even seem right. I mean, here I am. No, I have the most popular man. Not to seem conceited. I'm not being conceited to myself. But I know. I am the most sought after man in all of the city, in all of the country. And to give up that, to follow a man, I don't even know who he is. Don't even know who he is. Just some teacher that is great miracles. He's doing great miracles. I have to admit to that. But how do I know he's right? How do I know he's right? I don't know. My rabbi doesn't think he's right, and my rabbi has taught me from age zero and up. My father. What would my father say if I came to him and said, "Well, Father, you just handed me title, seal to your land. You gave me your sealing ring at the gates. And now I'm at this teacher, and I'm just going to give it all away. I'm going to sell it, but, you know, I probably should sell it at not exactly market value, probably a whole lot less. And basically, I'm going to now follow this man. I don't know. No, I don't know him. And that's it. You'll see no more of me. Now you can have my five brothers and that's it. No, he'd absolutely think I'm absolutely crazy. He'd say, you know, who's been teaching you? Have we been teaching you all these years, or has, you know, nobody, and then suddenly this man comes up and you're going to follow him right away? I don't think so. I just do not think so. I am, it's too much for me to give. Too much for me to give. I haven't come to my checklist today. Look at this. I am a good man. I'm a good man. Look, I have all my checks in my first boxes and checks in my second boxes. Surely these, just to give all I have, just you know, it's possession? Is that what it is? Just, you know, surely by today, I was respectful to my parents today. And yes, mother taught me to be charitable to the poor again. I was at the synagogue with my rabbi. We did prayer. Goodness sakes, I got an atta box for my scripture memorizations. Surely this is enough. This is not my first checklist. I am the best man. I know I am. I know I am. And I know the leadership of my father, the leadership of my rabbi, the leadership of my mother, the peers about me. And I'm just going to throw that aside for then this man's bidding, his leadership. How do I even know his leadership's right? And I have to put all my trust in that. When I put all my trust... And what is around me now? No, 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 no. It's too much. And I don't think that is what he really wanted. I think he was suggesting that I do such. And everything that I've done thus far is good enough. And I know he understands. And I just can't do that. I just can't do that. That's it. Nope. I'll put my pen here and I feel a whole lot better. See? That's what all that learning has done for me. It helps me to reason it all out. I know it does. That's what my rabbi has done. He throws these questions at me, and I have to sort them all out. I have to trust in their influence and their leadership for me. And now I can rest fitfully for the night. That's better.
It is Gentlemen.
Ah, my son. How
Thank
are
you for coming.
No
I'm
problem.
So excited, huh?
Must get rid of this robe here.
You sounded this, excited when
I
you called.
I am indeed. This chair can go here. We got...
Oh, what do we have for today?
Well, remember, I was talking to you earlier regarding property and whatnot. And I know a little bit of time is spanned, but these things take time. However, I didn't really allude to much. But here's the plan. Do you know the old barns?
Yes.
The two old barns that we've had storing all that various storage, our crops that come in, the different supplies for the different stores. It's just getting too much. Just too much. Mm. We need to expand.
I see.
We need to expand. So, I acquired. This is our current property as of right now. Our current property are lying here.
Yes.
And our barns are at about such. And, of course, you can see the outline of the second barn.
Yes.
Okay. What I've done is I've acquired this plot of land here.
All of this?
All of this, including
oh,
yep.
Son, that's an enormous undertaking.
Absolutely. But I know it's possible. I've ran the calculations. I've done the financial analysis. I've done it all.
Good.
Just as you taught me, Father. And we're going to tear these barns down. Tear them down. Absolutely.
Not just add to them?
No. You know what? They're too old. They're not just...
They're good barns.
No, dry rot through all the different... forget it. No, not worth the time. So, therefore, we'll tear them down, and I am going to build a large one right here, just like so. It's roughly 3 to 4 times the size of our current barn.
From here to here.
Absolutely. We'll leave a little bit of a perimeter, but I feel we should stretch it and maximize the density of this on our plot of land.
One barn to replace the
one
two.
Not giant. Just one. I'm going to add another.
Oh,
I'm going to add another.
Two barns.
Absolutely. I know we can. God has blessed us where our old barns are just stock full. We need to not just relocate, not just add on, but just tear new barns. What do you think?
It's feasible.
I know it's feasible.
I know it's feasible. In fact, your little house is up here, and I'm relocating you.
My house.
Newer house. Newer, bigger, and better.
Well, that is good.
Absolutely. I thought you'd like that little addition there.
Now, son, remember this. I've taught you, whenever you say, I will, always add the words, God willing.
Of course.
God willing.
Of course.
Always, son.
But
if God wills it, then it will happen.
Right. But we're definitely putting these barns here. I know it's God's blessing.
He's blessed us.
We've multiplied it in all of our business activities, and we need these barns. In fact, construction starts tomorrow.
So tomorrow. Soon.
Absolutely.
My.
My son.
That's it. That's what I wanted to take your time up with.
All of that for this. Unbelievable.
I thought you'd like that.
Mm. I leave you to it.
Thank you. I will keep you both updated.
It's good.
Yes,
bless you both.
Very good.
Absolutely. I'll let the shock of that go, and then I'll let you know what the return on our investment is tomorrow. It's quite high. Thank you. Lydia, can I please have my Jerusalem Post? Please. Thank you.
You are master.
Thank you. Please, I would like, just a simple water with a little bit of ice, please. Thank you. Oh,
Jerusalem Post. What's the day God for us today?
Lazarus dies. The unknown body of a man found dead last evening has been identified. The dead man is the beggar Lazarus, who appears to have died as a result of chronic disease and malnutrition. Common. He has no remaining family, and there will be no memorial service. Lazarus, the name rings a bell. I know who he is. He's the man that was outside my gates. I know that was him. He was the one praying. He had seen Jesus in Nazareth and was praying outside my window that night. I remember that. He was repenting. Interesting. He was giving, if I recall what he was saying, he was
giving all he had. Giving all he had. Funny, he didn't have too much to give. How ironic. I was asked to sell all I had. That was a little bit too much. I didn't think it was necessary. And then he says, well, I'll give. He prays and says, I'll give all I have. And he doesn't have hardly anything to give. That's pretty simple stuff. If I was in that position, I would have done the same thing. So simple for him to do such when he has so little. Interesting. So be it. Not a beggar off the street.
Thou fool, this night thy soul be required of thee.
Oh. Goodness.
Oh! 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 Ah!
Thank you.
dip his finger in water! Make cool my tongue! I'm tormented in his leg!
Son, remember that thou in thy lifetime receivest thy good things. Likewise, Lazarus, evil things.
No!
But now he is comforted, and thou art tormented.
But surely something can be done!
And beside all this, between you and us, there is a great gulf fixed.
No,
so that they which would pass to you from hence cannot, neither can they pass to us which would come from thence.
But send him to my father's house! Send him to my brothers! That they will believe!
They have Moses and the prophets. Let them hear them.
Oh God! How could they believe? I didn't believe Moses and the prophets! That's what I was being! I thought that was enough! Oh God, I didn't listen to you! Lord, I knew I should have listened to you, God! Lord, you came by my way! Lord, you passed by, oh God, and I didn't give my everything! Lord, you were leading me, you were calling me! But Lord, I decided to listen, Lord, to those that were around me. Oh God, it wasn't good enough. Lord, I had to give my all. Surely who can do something now? Lord, go to those that are behind me. Lord, that they may not come to such a place. Lord, take their souls, oh God. Bend them to your side, oh God. Oh God, and they don't see you come to torment. Oh God.
My cross, bear the
Well? Sobering, isn't it? I think it's very, very sobering. You know, Brother Bram said in souls that are in prison, he said, I've been to both places. Both places. He said, I went into that place. And you've got your friends around you. You might listen to those kind of voices, but one thing thou lackest. You know, when you go into that region, there will be no friends there. Your little cronies and your little buddies, they will not be there. Brother Branham said when he fell into that region, he cried out for his mother, as you heard this evening. And guess what? His mother wasn't there. He cried out for his father, that one that influenced him, that he looked to and respected. But his father wasn't there. There will be absolutely nobody there for you. You have to make a decision tonight. You have to make a choice. Whether the voice of God has been speaking to you over the last few weeks and months, and you've held off. And you've held off. Maybe just like that rich young ruler, you say, well, that's just a story. That is not just a story. Because Jesus made reference to a certain man. He was telling of an actual happening. This is not some dramatization that is of a figment of our imagination. This is absolutely reality. And you have to make the choice tonight which way you want to go. You say, why is the Holy Spirit trying to reach out? Because there's young men here and young ladies that are weighing in the balances. And you haven't given your all. Thou lackest one thing. I've got my youth. I've got my beauty. I'll wear my garments in a certain way that will cause an attraction. One thing thou lackest, young lady. How about you, young man? One thing thou lackest. I wonder whether you can actually hear the voice of God speaking to you. Because you know what it is? It's a still small voice saying, surrender. Surrender. Surrender the drugs. Surrender the cigarettes. Surrender the booze. You see, is that amongst us? One thing thou lackest. There will be a region that you can't reach out to anybody. But there's one that's reaching out to you tonight. I look at a young man that's sitting there. And by the grace of God, at a young age, a decision was made. He doesn't have to go to that realm. And there's many of you that have made a decision, and you will never have to go to that realm. You're going to another realm. It's called the region of the blessed. It's one endless day without a night. It's glorious, I do declare. Holy angels will be there. The Lord Jesus Christ will be there. Amen. And we'll sing throughout the ages. But Brother Branham said, don't ever go to that place. He said it would be like opening your body, hot wires going through you, and acid being poured into you. You say, you're trying to be dramatic. I say, I can't even be more as dramatic as that prophet was dramatic. But I say to you tonight, that's a real place. That's a real place. I say, run from that place. Run to Christ. Run to Him. How do you do it? Simple. Simple. You just
reach out your hand to Him and say, Lord, that one thing I surrender to You tonight, I'm laying it on the altar. I'm saying I'm not going that way. Weigh it out. He weighed it out. But I'm good. I come to church. I don't murder people. Look at the checklist. Jesus said, honor thy mother, thy father. You say, I do that. He kept the commandments. Jesus loved him. And I'm saying to you tonight, I believe Jesus loves you. And He's calling to you. And I believe at this time and at this season, let God come on the scene. Vindicate His word. Why don't you that are maybe been weighing and on the fence, why don't you be a man? Why don't you be a lady tonight and say, I'm not going to go that way. I'm tired of that up and down Christian life. I want to walk on with the word. I need God. I want the Holy Ghost in my life. I'm willing to surrender to Him. Maybe you want to come up here and you want us to pray. We'll pray with you. I'll tell you, last night we had little girls that took their hands and said, oh Jesus, I don't want to go that way. I had little men reach up to my arm and say, Brother Tom, will you pray with me? I wonder, is there men enough tonight that said, I'm going to take the way with the Lord's despised you? That's not a story. That is reality. And are you willing tonight to surrender to that, or is your heart too hard? I believe the Holy Spirit is here to deliver you and to set you free by the power of the presence of God. As we sing this song, all He wants is you. And you make that decision tonight. I believe that that's what this camp is all about. I believe this is the start of what the Lord's going to do within your life. Saints, it's only going to get more glorious and more glorious and more glorious. But you got to have a starting point. And tonight is your starting point. Why don't you surrender to Him? Why don't you run to Jesus? Why don't you come up here tonight? As we sing the chorus, we'll pray with you. Your pastor is here. Brother Ron is here. Brother John is here. Brother Diddy is here. These are men of God that can pray for you. Why don't you make a decision as we sing this chorus? Is all of you all He wants? Just come if God has really dealt with your heart tonight. And I say, God bless your honest soul. All He wants is you. Just make your way up here. Hallelujah. Tonight is my night. No more roller coaster, Lord. But actually a time where there's a complete surrenderance. A surrenderance to God, Dad. Where God has His way. Make your way right over here. That'd be fine. All He wants is me. Oh, I'm reservedly not just a part. He wants all of. Oh, all He wants is all. Do you mean it tonight? Can you mean it tonight? You heard how that rich young ruler cried out in that region of the lost. Surely tonight, when hell has moved itself into this dimension, surely you can call out tonight, not in just lip service, but saying, Lord, hear my humble cry. While on others Thou art calling, do not pass me by. Hear me, Lord. I mean it tonight, Lord.